So we have the pro meeting right now. It's 4:30 in the afternoon before all the amateur competitors arrive. All the pros head on in, and we have a briefing with Pauline and Ari. A little update on how things are going with WBFF Australia. So this is the man of the moment. Ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, well,
ladies and gentlemen, I believe Robbie Frame is in the building.
Johnny Trey's on the mic.
More swagger than Conor McGregor.
He's got it.
Man, it's so good to see you. Looking great.
Going well.
This
going
is
well.
It.
Mate, Matt from the South, how are you? You good?
Good to see you.
How you feeling?
Yeah.
Tired. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I'm really tired.
I'm ready. I'm going to bring
Robbie Frame in the building, and we live and direct at the WBFF registration pro athlete meeting. He's getting ready to go down.
All right, I am here with the people's champion. I am here with Hattie Boydle. Talk me through your experience over there in lovely Las Vegas.
I had the best time. I always say to my mum, Mom, I'm having the best time. I haven't even got on stage. And one, just to be there with people. The interaction and the love and the support I get from my competitors and just people who are part of the WFF, I just think I'm so lucky, you know, and I was ready to get on stage. I was like months before, I was like, just hurry up, like I'm waiting. I wanted to bring my best and I felt like I really honored it. And it's funny because I did a lot more cardio than what I would usually do in a prep this year. But every morning I would have this podcast on, and it was Muhammad Ali, and it would say, I'ma show you how great I am. And I would have that on repeat. I'ma show you how great I am. So before I went on stage, where I know I'm really nervous every year without fail, I was like, I'ma show you how great I am. And when I walked out, I honored that. I did the best I could. And I walked off stage and I said, Mom, I did the best I could. Yeah. She goes, Hattie, it was like you were back again.
Yeah.
And I really had a great time.
I believe, honestly, the improvements that you've made over the last 12 months have been absolutely incredible. Your physique was on another level, and you could tell that from 7 weeks out. We had the WBFF Sydney show, and I can already see the definition through your deltoids. You really were bringing the Hattie Boydle package that I know you envisage and you really wanted to bring, and you certainly brought it. But quite honestly, the most iconic moment of those world championships would have to be that photo where Stephanie, yourself, and who placed third, there was another girl that placed third. You have to strut the stage after the award's been given, and in your most vulnerable state after giving your whole self to a prep, you were in a position where, you know, you're going to see someone's true raw emotions and character come out of the woodwork. And Stephanie's crown for this year's championship was actually tilted, about to fall off during the presentation. And Hattie took the time and effort to stop what she was doing because the photo's been taken, realign the crown, stop, pause, make sure that it was actually going to stay, and then got the photos taken. And I think, for me, honestly, that's the most iconic moment, because in an industry which is so caught up in the external appearance and very much an independent one-man journey at times, you can often lose sight of the big picture and celebrating other people's wins. And in that moment, you celebrated her win and made sure that she was in the limelight, which speaks volumes about Hattie's character. That's it.
And that's it. And I improved, and I think, far out, what am I going to do next year? Because it's not over till I win, you know what I'm saying? But it's just like, you know, to improve on the package I had this year, it's going to be tough, and I can't wait. Like, I'm so excited for it. And now it's Robbie's turn. It's Robbie's turn to burn that stage down, and I cannot wait to see what this guy has under this suit. Ladies and gentlemen, I got a little sneak peek of his legs. Just wait till you see the rest of it. Very excited.
Stay tuned. I am here with the engine room and behind the WBFF Australia. We have got the head promoter Ari and the head judge Pauline, who are here on the eve of the inaugural WBFF Australian International Pro-Am. Guys, how are we feeling with what, less than 12 hours to go, really?
Nervous?
I'm excited. Do you know what I mean? It's like, we've done all the hard work.
Yes.
I hope Pauline has.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
Pauline, we've got everything here. Aru, actually a little bit nervous because we've got so many competitors.
We've got 300 competitors.
Wow.
So pretty much doubled.
Wow.
Doubled for the first program.
So we've had three shows in total this year.
Yeah.
And this is the biggest show, you reckon?
Oh, ever, we've ever had today. Ever. So yeah,
since you've been the promoter 4 years now.
Our fourth year now. So we started it, and that was in
2015.
So we had two shows. Then we grew it to. We have two shows the second year, three shows this year.
Yes. Yep. This year we added in the transformation category.
Yeah, that was a phenomenal.
Wasn't it great?
Phenomenal stories. It just showed that, you know, the WBFF, whilst we do push the notion of being the best of the best and offering that platform to these premium high-end fitness models, fitness is not exclusive just to those that choose to make it their profession or, you know, are big fitness buffs or bodybuilding enthusiasts. Yeah. It's for everyone.
Yeah.
I mean, the stories behind the transformations, and it was the hardest job for the judges to determine who should actually take home the top gong because it often gets said, well, everyone's a winner. Truth be told, some of the stories that we were hearing and the insane. Not just the physical, but the psychological transformation that they were making, the mental development, absolutely phenomenal overall.
It was crazy.
So the Sydney show
will have the transformation. We've got our first pro show tomorrow, which Robbie's getting ready for.
I'm getting ready.
Shredder will be stalking. Paulie's been stalking him, so she stalks everyone, and we'll say
on the legs.
Yeah, we'll say in about. That's probably the best condition we've seen so far. So we'll wait to see tomorrow.
Yeah, looking forward to it.
And Robbie's always a phenomenal ambassador for WBFF. We're so lucky to have you too, and it's great. And we really appreciate you more than you know that you're doing our first show.
Yeah,
our first pro show. Which is great.
I was first one in line registered.
Yes, he was great. Do you know?
It's just growing from strength to strength, guys. Yeah. So whether or not you're a prospective athlete or perhaps you're just a fitness enthusiast that's inspired more by one of the many WBFF athletes on stage, make sure that you take the opportunity next year to find your way to a WBFF show. Trust me when
I say. Come and check it out. It's different.
It's phenomenal.
So different. Like, do you know, it's not for everyone. Do you know when I get that? But I mean, most people who see it, they're blown away by it.
Exactly.
You know?
Absolutely phenomenal event. Looking forward to the rest of registration. I thank you very much, Ari and Pauline.
And good luck, Robbie, for tomorrow.
You want to compete in WBFF?
I love fitness and fashion, so it kind of combines the two together, and being surrounded by such beautiful people and just the whole vibe of the whole competition, it's going to be really amazing. I'm really excited.
I am here with Kim Speechley. She is a Competitive Edge podcast member, frequent listener. How you feel? You're doing, what category are you doing tomorrow?
Bikini tour.
And how are you feeling? Very first comp?
Very first comp, so I'm very excited about it. Not nervous just yet, but we'll wait till tomorrow, but very excited.
Yeah, very first competition here with the WBFF. Excitement is a fever pitch. You look drop dead gorgeous. How's the prep going?
The prep has been fantastic. My first
concludes the registration evening for the inaugural WBFF Australian Pro-Am. All the glitz and the glamour that make the WBFF what it is was on display this evening. You get to see not only first-class physiques on stage tomorrow, but you get to see everyone dressed to the nines, dressed to impress. We certainly bring the fashion into the WBFF. It will undoubtedly be a memorable event tomorrow here at the Star on the glorious Gold Coast. I cannot wait, but for the time being, I'm going to get my tan, and then I'm going to eat a hell of a lot of food.
Whereabouts are we?
The car park at the Star. never thought I would be having chicken with sweet potato, iceberg lettuce. I've actually sprinkled some cinnamon on as well. In the Star at the casino, the bloody casino.
Okay, so finally back here at the Airbnb. We arrived at registration at the casino at 4:30. Well, 4:30 was the athlete briefing. Then we had that little pit stop in the car park for food. Had the tan. Got to sleep in this lovely tan. Fortunately, I've got extra sheets I brought from home so we don't damage. So, at this particular point in time, I've had all my food for today. The thing that we're gonna do now is prepare some food for tomorrow. And right now, rest, recover, recuperate. Sleep's really important at this particular point in time. Getting my feet up, elevating my feet, and just relaxing, because I wanna be able to conserve energy in preparation for tomorrow. Paolo, how am I looking? All right.
Fantastic, man. Fantastic. You should pull up nice and dry and tight tomorrow. Look, I've got him just where he needs to be right now, so it's going to be a big day. It's going to be a big day.
So the number one priority is just to get some sleep now.
Rest, man. I'll take care of the food.
And this is where it helps having my coach here with me. In LA, we were constantly going back and forth via correspondence, messaging each other, and at times it can be overwhelming, but fortunately Polo's always been proactive. He's seeking out the updates, but just having him face to face to be able to see my condition firsthand and get a better understanding of how I'm looking, whether I'm full, dry condition.
He cooks the chicken.
I cook the chicken. And just having that firsthand account really provides me with the reassurance and confidence that I need that we're on the right track. So now we're just going to get into a bit of meal prep before it's time to snooze. Until next time, guys, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.